this is what makes college football great. Yeah, there's history and tradition, but right here, right now, there is tremendous intensity and bitterness on this field. You can feel it. As we'll see the number 9 team in the land, the Michigan Wolverines, taking on the second-ranked team, the Ohio State Buckeyes. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, joined here in the booth by Kirk Herbstreit. Kirk, let's get to the action on the field. The Wolverines will kick this away to start us off. And he'll lead the kickoff right there. He'll start from the 25. So Ohio State's offense comes on the field to open this game. And here we go. Wolverines, the Buckeyes, everything that's gone into this game for 365 days is about to play out right now, Kirk.
And there's just something right, when you look out on that field and you see the colors on the field competing against each other. Maize and blue and scarlet and gray. Let's see what happens. Nice throw and catch here for the Buckeyes. You know, Chris, it's hard to think of a time when Ohio State didn't have an efficient and prolific quarterback under center.
This line getting set up. It's a first down play. Off the play fake, looking to throw. And they hit him just as he releases the ball. It's incomplete. Well, for many, this is the quintessential college football rivalry. It combines tradition, high intensity, and very often, high stakes.
Yeah, Chris, I really think the rivalry has changed over the years. Guys in my era would tell you it was a game that was the most heated, but the most respected because of the way you were recruited by both schools. There was the Woody, there was the Bo influence on the rivalry. But I think in the new social media era, I think it's more about hatred for the two schools. From both sides, it's just a different feel. We'll feel that today when these teams go at it.
They come to the line, a long way to go for the first down, but needing this crucial conversion right now. Looking to pass, it's Howard. QB to the tight end for a completion. Defense will wrap him up after an 8-yard gain. It'll bring up fourth down.
On third downs like this, you can only allow completions in front of you as long as you can protect the sticks. And that's what the defense did here. They knew where the sticks were, and they're able to make the tackle short of the line.
The Buckeyes will have to punt this one away. Running it back, it's Morgan. And the coverage team gets the returner to the ground. The Wolverines offense takes the field, our first chance to see them today. And how about the game within a game today? The running back coming downhill, the linebacker coming up to meet him. We expect some collisions on this field today.
Yeah, this linebacker's going to have his hands full because this running back is a difficult guy to contain. Both guys know where each other's going to be lined up at all times. It's just going to come down to which guy can come up and make a play against the other. The defense there showed incredible discipline on the backside contain, and that reverse wasn't going anywhere. Just textbook.
Just underway, and this home crowd is fired up and ready to make a difference today. Fakes the handoff, looking to throw. And he cannot make the catch over the middle on the crossing route. It's going to bring up third down. You recall the last time they played, the Wolverines won a very close game. That has not been forgotten in Columbus for a single minute since then.
No, and if I remember right, it was the Michigan defense that really stepped up and prevailed and led them to a close victory the last time out. Let's see what happens today if the Buckeyes offense can make the adjustments.
Caught behind the line. It's Moore. Defense stops him short of the marker, so now it's fourth down.
Well, the defense plays it pretty well. Force the quarterback to make the throw in front of you as a defense. Then you square up and make the tackle. Force them to do something special after the catch. The tactic works here. Now we've got a fourth down.
And the Wolverines bring their punt team onto the field. And the returner elects to fair catch it. No return. And the Ohio State offense comes back onto the field. They were forced to punt last time. Can they get this offense going finally? Get some points out of this possession. Makes a quick catch. Heads out of bounds as a short gain on the play.
We see this all over the country now in college football. Defensive backs staying back a little bit deeper, forcing the quarterback to have to throw things in front. I like the decision here by the quarterback positive yards. It's a good way of staying ahead of the chains.
And completion makes it second and short. To throw, it's Howard. Short throw to the back, an easy completion. They've got him, but that completion good enough for first down yardage. The running back sneaks out there. He is a difficult matchup for this defense in the passing game.
And it is so tough to match up in man-to-man coverage against a back like this and catch the ball like a receiver. It's something you work on all week, and you know about it. You're aware of it, but it's one thing to be aware of it, and another thing to go out and execute it and try to stay within the man coverage. Very tough to do.
Receiver brought down after a short pitch and catch.
Love to see the short passing game as a great go-to for any offensive coordinator in the first quarter because it's reliable and allows you to see how the defense is reacting. That can open up for other things later on.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Quarterback drops back. We're going to test the secondary. And he dumps it off to the tight end. A big hit by the linebacker, able to knock him down.
Boy, that's pretty good coverage here by this defense. Not much of a window to throw this ball into, but the quarterback's accuracy and the size of the tight end picks up a nice game.
Crucial third down play after that completion. Snags a quick throw. And the runner steps out of bounds, but does have enough yardage to pick up the first down.
Man, you just continue to see the chemistry between these two. And they told us yesterday in our production meeting, they spent hours and hours of working and developing that chemistry and that rhythm by throwing together throughout those summer months. And man, it's starting to really pay off. He's become his security blanket for the quarterback, and especially on third down, get him the ball.
He pulls in the catch, breaks a tackle into the clear. They bring him down, but an explosive play by this offense. Big game.
What a pitch and catch by the quarterback and receiver for a big game for this offense.
Offense racing down the field. It sets up a first and goal inside the 10. QB decides to keep it here. Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there.
Well, the quarterback does everything right except pitch the football. The defensive end's going to take him, which is great. That's what you want. But you got to get that ball out quicker to not allow that defensive end to make that play.
So the ball moved back to the 12 for second and goal. Trying for the end zone, running it right up the gut. Defense gets him down, but they'll take the gain on that play.
Just love watching this back run. Gets behind that offensive line, lowers his pads, and gets a nice, solid game.
So 8 plays into this drive now. It's third and goal. Looking to throw. It's Howard. Quarterback escapes the pocket and takes off. Trying to run it in, but the defense stops him short of the goal line.
Oh, my gosh, Chris. I thought he was going to be able to find a way to get to the end zone. He is such a threat when he takes off. He pulls that ball down and tries to get to the end zone on these scrambles. But the defense just keeps him out of the goal line.
So they're short on fourth down, and the coach decides to trot out the field goal team. The kick is good. He knocked it right down the middle. It breaks the scoreless tie here, makes it 3-0.
Well, they almost put a touchdown on the board, but instead they come away with 3 points.
They come away with 3 points on the drive, and now the kickoff team will boot it away. They'll return it from inside the 5. And the coverage team able to bring him down. And the Michigan offense back out on the field. This group is coming off a quick 3 and out. Can they put something together in this drive? Out of the shotgun, he'll hand it off. They'll bring him down just short of the 20.
Nice solid run here by this back. Did a nice job of just kind of finding that lane. Pick up some positive yards there on 1st and 10.
Getting set. Here's 2nd down.
course of a game, by the fourth quarter, you're going to start to see that affect the defense.
Solid gain on the running play. Third down now. It's a handoff to the wide receiver trying to make the yardage. Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there.
Well, the backside rules for a defense against the run are to check for the cutback, the counter, or reverse. By the time they stayed home and were in perfect position, they were able to stop that reverse in its track.
The Wolverines will send the punt team onto the field. And he'll kick it away now for the second time. Returner decides to fair catch this. Okay, here comes the Ohio State offense back on the field. The last possession, they moved it, but settled for a chip shot. So it's sort of an unsatisfying result. Looking to do more here. Caught over the middle. It's Scott. Tackle is made very near midfield. Good enough for a first down.
Just another great example, Chris, of an Ohio State quarterback and receiver combination being so dangerous. Think about it. Over the last 8 or 10 years, I think Ohio State has been as consistent as anybody when it comes to the passing game and the efficiency that comes with it.
Again, thrown out of the RPO, and it's complete. And he's brought down, but there is a penalty marker out there. Let's check out this call. And the head coach will decide to accept the penalty and take the yardage. Big guys up front lined up. It's first down. And they'll give it to the back. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one. Well, Kirk, Ohio State has the lead here after one. And at the end of the first quarter, let's check out the stats so far. They flipped ends of the field. We're ready now for the second period. Now it's second down here. Off the play fake, looking to throw the football. It's incomplete. He took a hit as he threw the football, and it brings up a third down.
Man, you got to love this if you're defensive coordinator. It's all about affecting the quarterback and getting pressure on him. This time, they got to him and forced that incompletion.
Challenging play for the offense. They face third and long here from their own 43. To the air. It's Howard. Stepping to his right now to avoid the pressure. Trying to use his legs to make the first down. Couldn't get there. And now it's a fourth down call.
Boy, he comes up just short of his first down, but a nice job of picking up some yards on third and long. Sometimes you just have to take what the defense gives you. And in this case, it wasn't quite enough to pick up the first down, but he gives them a chance.
And at fourth down, they'll punt it away here. And he puts it out of bounds, so no return. And the Wolverines offense is back on the field. Last time was a quick three and out. Can they get a drive going this time? They'll run it here. Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there.
Chris, I think we all kind of get caught up in third down. What's an offense doing on third down? But I think what's also important is how well you defend first down. If you can hold your opponents to a short gain or a tackle for a loss, you throw the offense out of whack, and their game plan gets much more challenging to try to come up with that.
And now the ball comes out. That'll be a safety.
Man, that is a big-time play by this defense, and the only way they can score points without getting a turnover. That should give this team a spark.
So out to the safety, it's now a free kick coming up. They'll punt it away from the 20. Choosing to return the punt. Here comes the powerful Ohio State offense onto the field. They're trying to build on their lead. They were forced to punt on the last possession. Here comes the handoff. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss.
just had nowhere to go. Got to give credit to the defense and their run fits on that play.
Here's the second down play. It's a quarterback keeper and brought down at the line by that big defensive tackle.
Boy, the options dried up quickly for the quarterback here. Very, very fortunate he was somehow able to get back to the line of scrimmage.
They're backed up here, trying to make something happen on third and long. Scanning the field, it's Howard. Receiver makes the catch. The defense will wrap him up after a 7-yard gain. It'll bring up fourth down. The Buckeyes will have to kick it away. And the coverage team makes the stop on this return. And the Michigan offense comes back out on the field. This offense trying to bounce back. The last time out there, they surrendered a safety. Trying to flex the ground game here. Running back takes the handoff.
Hey, listen, you don't always have to have big plays to be successful. It's a nice, solid gain here. Keeps you on schedule, and you get ready for that next play.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Caught in the backfield. It's Moore. And the defense swarms, not much of a gain on that completion.
Well, anytime an offensive coordinator calls a wide receiver screen, he's trying to get offensive linemen out in front of the receiver to create a wall so that receiver can pick a lane to run through. How about the defense here, though? That's called team pursuit and swarming to the football. They didn't give him any lanes, so not much yards downfield for the receiver.
Gonna pick up the third and short through the air. He's looking to scramble. And the junior quarterback shows his toughness, keeps this drive moving.
Boy, this is so deflating for this defense on third and short. Good coverage downfield. They take away all the short routes, but the one guy that they don't account for is the quarterback and his legs. Picks up the first down by being athletic there and great awareness.
The Wolverines getting set on first and 10. It's a shotgun run call. Breaks loose at the 45. And that gain enough for a fresh set of downs, spotted at the 48.
Of course they're going to pick up the first down by running the football. You think about Michigan, you think so many legacy, incredible backs that they've had over the years. Tim Biakabatuka and Tyrone Wheatley and Leroy Hoare. Man, so many good backs have come through Ann Arbor.
Running game is working. They'll stick with it on first down.
You know, a lot of people feel running backs with elite speed shy away from contact, but that wasn't the case there. Instead of running around the defender, this back elected to run right through him.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Play action fake, looking to throw. Caught near the sticks, it's Loveland. Tackle made after a big game.
That's a nice completion here by this Michigan offense. And when Michigan is really clicking, you think about over the years, they've been efficient within that passing game, being able to throw the football to complement a very physical running game. Nice play.
Time this offense gets going, it's a first and 10. And they'll run it out of the shotgun. And the sophomore able to bring him down quickly.
Nice job here of controlling the line of scrimmage by this offensive line. The back does what he needs to do to get positive yards on first down.
Offense getting set, second down play here. And the same runner has got it again.
Chris, Chris, that play just didn't have much of a chance at all from the snap. Quarterback hands this off and just nowhere to go. It's almost like the defense was anticipating the play call, and they put themselves in a position to come up with a nice tackle for a loss.
Third down here. Time for perhaps one more play before the two-minute warning. That's the two-minute warning in this close first half. The offense trying to score and claim the lead before the break. Now it's third and short in the 24. One of those line of scrimmage battles that could help decide this game. Off play action, he's looking to throw. Looking for the wide out. Looks downfield and finds a receiver who worked his way wide open.
Now that's what I call coming through for your team in a pressure situation. Great read, got the ball where it needed to go, and now you're set up to get six.
It is first and goal, a great chance to claim the lead before the break here. Back to pass, it's Orji. And he runs it in for the score. Touchdown, Wolverines. So they reach the end zone after a marathon march. How about the execution in that drive, Kirk?
Well, I know a lot of times people get excited for the big plays. They're fun to watch. But what's impressive to me is an offense that can put together a long drive and then finally cap it off with a touchdown. That way you don't have to always rely on the big plays. That's a great drive.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. Extra point makes it a two-point lead. Kickoff team has come on the field now to send this one away. Return starts from inside the five. It'll be tackled at the 17. Strong job by the coverage team. Okay, here comes the Ohio State offense back on the field. If they want to cut into this lead before halftime, they have to work quickly now. Here's a wide open receiver complete. That'll pick up first down yardage very near the 40.
You know, we talked this week with the offensive coordinator about what makes this receiver so special. He kept referring to his route running. Here's an example of that. Great route, enough separation to give the quarterback a nice lane to throw the football.
Buckeyes come to the line looking to crank up the tempo. Here comes a first down pass attempt. Grab down the middle. It's Smith. Breaks loose at the 40. And they stop it, but not before. An explosive play moves the ball all the way to the 32.
Well, it's one thing to hear about how fast this receiver is in the scouting report. You look at him on film all week. The defense coordinator tells you, get ready, this guy can run. And then the reality comes, and this guy can fly. You see it again here. Nice catch.
The drive stays alive with that first down completion. Scanning the field, it's Howard. Receiver looks it in. It's complete. And a timeout is called to talk strategy. Close game here as we approach halftime.
Chris, this guy has a big-time arm. He just zipped the ball in there. You know, you can sometimes show your arm strength in other ways than just bombing it deep.
Looking to pass here on second down. Caught over the middle. It's Henderson. The offense will now quickly spend a timeout.
One thing I love about this back is how he gets involved in the passing game. Nice catch here.
The Buckeyes will line up on first and 10. Offense looking to throw the ball. Grab down the middle. It's Scott. A huge hit by the linebacker. A collision of big bodies there.
Well, this is what coaches love to see. A quarterback with the ability to read the defense properly and then just get it to the open man. Sometimes it sounds simple, but it's tough to execute. This time we have good recognition by the quarterback. Then he gets it down to the tight end. You can see what he can do after the catch.
Caught over the middle. It's Abuka. The tackle is made, but the offense is now set up with a first and goal from the 8. That's a nice pickup there. They find some space in the zone and pick up the first down.
Yeah, really nice call here, Chris, to be able to pick up this first down on this drag route. The quarterback does a nice job of being patient, waiting for that window to open up in that zone, and he put it right on the money for the receiver. receiver to have a chance to not just catch it, but eventually get the first.
The pocket breaking down. The offense will quickly spend a timeout here after the play. So, with only a few seconds left in the half, out comes the field goal unit. This one is right through. And that field goal, the final play of this opening half. Is going to wrap up the first half here. Let's kick it now to Kevin Connors with our halftime update.
Fellas, whether it's in the shoe or the big house, when you have these two programs with all that's at stake today, you know emotions run high in a game known simply as the game. And it's been said football is a game of inches. And guess what? Based on the comparison between third down conversion rate today and the average yard per play, how can you argue that? I mean, the low-lying fruit is to look at some of the explosive plays we've seen and panic. But really, this game is going to come down to which team is more efficient when they have the ball and how they play when it matters most. With that, let's throw it back to the guys to see how this rivalry matchup plays out.
The Buckeyes will kick this away to begin the second half. Fields it inside the five-yard line. He'll be tackled at the 17. Strong job by the coverage team. And the Michigan offense back out on the field. Dropping back, it's Orangy. Looks to his left and makes the completion. Tackle made on the play at the 29-yard line.
Boy, a great slant by the receiver. What I love is the quarterback found the window that he wanted to make the accurate throw.
Offense keeps moving. It's a completion for a first down. Trying to find room. It's Edwards. And he will be stuffed for no gain.
That's an excellent effort here by this defense, staying in their run fits. They holding their own at the line and making the tackle. The offense just couldn't get enough of a push to get anything going there.
Important second down play coming up. Here's the snap, looking to throw. Gets made on the out route. They make the tackle, but that pass creates a solid gain.
The key here, Chris, is the timing by the quarterback. The fact he got the ball out quickly gave his receiver a chance. One more hitch or a slight hesitation, and that's an incompletion or an interception.
It's third down for the offense. They'll try to run for the first down. They make the stop just short of the marker. It's going to be fourth down and inches to go. And the Wolverines will send their punt team onto the field. He'll call for the fair catch here. Here comes the Buckeye offense onto the field. Kept out of the end zone last time, had to settle for a short field goal. Can they improve upon that here? On first down, it's play action. Let's it go quickly. Finds a man open on the right side downfield. They bring him down, but a big chunk of yardage on the play.
Boy, what a throw and catch again by the Ohio State Buckeye offense. You think about how Ohio State has been able to really grow over the years. Go back and think about Chris Carter back in the 80s and Joey Galloway in the 90s. And, of course, most recently with Garrett Wilson and Chris Olave, Jackson Smith and Jigba. So many great receivers, and it's been fun to watch this young man today.
Quarterback pulls the ball. It's a keeper. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
And it's a nice job by this defense. They saw option, actually forced the quarterback to pull the ball on the read, and then they corral him for a loss. You could tell they worked
hard on that in practice.
Second down after that previous play. Handoff here from the shotgun.
Fights through a tackle.
Did well to avoid a loss there, but it's no gain on the play.
Well, the defensive line does their job eating up those double teams, freeing up the backers to make the play.
So the offense getting set. This is not where you want to be against this defense. Third and long. Dropping back. Looking to throw for the first down. And they chase him down outside the pocket for a sack.
Great call here going with that nickel defense, giving you more speed on the field on that third down and long. Nowhere to go. Gave the defensive line plenty of time to come up with that sack. Now it's fourth down and long.
Buckeyes will line up to kick it away. Back out to punt for the fourth time today. That takes a big bounce and rolls all the way into the end zone for a touchback. And the Wolverines offense is back on the field. Which offense can get it going first? This one has been a struggle so far. Gets the first and still running. And bulldozing his way through. Finally brought down, but the game moves it to the 44. They trust the left side of that offensive line and come up with a huge play on the ground.
Yeah, your favorite, Chris, there. The old pin and pull there to the left side. Great blocking on the left side, able to create a great push. Nice crease in the back, found that with the vision and picks up some big yards for that first down.
First down and 10 now. And it's incomplete. The defender arrived the same time as the football, and now it's second down.
Well, I'm a big fan of the RPO, but it is a dangerous play for the quarterback. You got to make the right decision. And on this play, it just seemed like he was a little hesitant, unsure, and it cost him here with an incompletion.
Incompletion makes it second down. Back to throw. It's Orji. Quick throw to the left side, and he's got it. Tackle is made, but the game sets the offense up. First and goal from the 9.
Defense kind of lost the running back here. Makes a nice catch and gets the first down in the process.
So that huge gain quickly sets up a first and goal just inside the 10. Trying to run, it's Edwards. Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there. Well, that was that excellent linebacker with a clear path just running downhill quickly.
You know, I think one of the great things about watching this guy play all year is his vision. He just has great instincts. That time the defensive line ate up all the linemen, freed up the linebacker to get into the backfield, and the result is a tackle for a loss for the backer.
Fakes the handoff here, looking to throw it. Looking to the end zone. Touchdown, Michigan. And they will claim the second half lead.
Well, that's just textbook right there. Great timing and recognition by the quarterback. Great route by this receiver. He gave a nice stem to the outside before he went to the post. Perfect timing, tough to defend, and an easy touchdown for this offense.
The offense will go for a 2-point conversion. There's the snap. Looking to throw the ball. And a short pass caught in the end zone. They convert the 2-point try. Kickoff team is on the field to boot this one away. He's going to bring it out of the end zone from a couple yards deep. They tackle him at the 9. That's good coverage. They should have left the ball. time they were forced to punt it away. Can they get points out of this possession? Play action here on first down. Quick throw over the middle. And he finds a wide open receiver. They forgot about him downfield. They bring him down, but that is a huge play for this passing game. Big game.
Boy, just a great job by this quarterback of being able to put this ball up in the air to give his receiver a chance to time that up perfectly for a huge gain for the offense.
The Buckeyes hustle to the line to run the hurry up. Takes the handoff. It's Henderson. Showcasing the shiftiness on that play, defense finally brings him down.
I'll take that every single time. Offensive line does a nice job up front. This back's vision and ability to get positive yards by lowering his pads on full display right there.
Again, makes it second and medium. Here's the toss play now, running left. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of two.
Well, that's a great play all around by this defense. Your first level defenders hold their own at the point of attack, allowing the second and third level players to roam free and make the tackle close to the line of scrimmage.
So the ball at midfield, and now the offense facing a third and long. That's the wide receiver coming in motion now. Play action fake, looking to throw. Finds a man downfield. That's a big gain to the right. Tackled at the 33. That's good enough for a first down.
This is a big conversion by this offense. They're down now in the second half. Probably limited opportunities at this point in the game. Every chance you get your hands on the ball, you need points. They keep this drive alive right here.
The Buckeyes moving quickly down the field here. From the shotgun, it's a handoff. As the first down is still going, they bring him down, but an explosive play by this offense. Big game.
Big runs like this are just demoralizing for a defense. It's one thing to give up big plays over your head against the pass game. When teams can run the ball and pick up yards like this, it really affects the team's mental psyche and their confidence. And you'll start to see some missed tackles following a play like this.
It's the senior getting home with the sack. So Kirk, Michigan has the lead here at the end of the quarter. We've reached the end of the third. Time is running out to cut into this lead. Let's check out the game stats before we go on. We're set now for the fourth quarter. Who is going to make the crucial plays to take home this W? Second and long for this offense after the sack. Back to throw. It's Howard. He's got it, looking for the end zone. The tackle is made, but there's a flag on the field. Let's see what that's about. That one hurts. Backs him up 10 yards. Second down play coming up for this offense. From the gun, he looks for an open man. Pass ball is incomplete. There was a lot of contact. No penalty. Brings up third down.
Chris, I thought he had his hands on that football. I thought he was going to come down with it. But give the defense all the credit with a big hit to knock that ball loose.
Seventh play of the drive coming up, but it is third down and long. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw it. They've got him. It's a sack for the defense.
And just like that, you squeeze the life out of this offense. That's another sack by this defense. They have been in that backfield the entire game, and a big reason why these guys are enjoying a lead.
So on fourth down, out trots the place kicker in a very big spot here. And he's got it from 49 yards. takes this from inside the five. And they stop him at the 23. That's solid coverage. And the Michigan offense comes back out on the field. Crucial possession. This game just got tighter. They love to play keep away, chew on the clock. How will they call it here? They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
Things just appeared to be a bit out of sync from the get-go on that one. Give credit to the front seven of that defense for staying in the proper lanes and getting to the ball carrier, not let him dance around and make something out of nothing.
After the loss on first down, it's second and long from the 22. Dropping back, it's Orji. Receiver makes the grab. Tackle made after a solid gain. They'll spot the ball at the 34.
Now the receiver does all the work here. Man, that is easy living for this quarterback. Really good footwork by the receiver. Gets the separation. And at that point, it's just pitch and catch for the quarterback.
Fresh set of downs for the offense. First down. Here's the snap. Quarterback drops back. Quick completion to the tight end. But a huge collision. Blow delivered there by the linebacker.
Just a good job of spreading the wealth, making sure everybody's getting their touches. When you do that, the defense can't lock in on one guy or two guys. Make them have to be aware of everybody. It allows you to continue to spread the ball around and spread the field, making it tougher for this defense.
Quarterback looking to throw it on second down. Caught quickly. Brought down, it crosses midfield to the 46. They bring him down, but the junior quarterback showing off the cannon.
I just continue to be in awe of this offense. Even with the lead, these guys are going to play for 60 minutes. They do not let up. Here they are. Typically, you want to run the football here to work the clock, but these guys stick to the game plan and keep throwing the football, trying to get more yards.
Takes the handoff. It's Edwards. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup.
I like the run play here, and offensively at this point in the game, you want to remain in that attack mode first while also staying in bounds and working that clock.
Offense getting set up. Here's second down. They're going to run it, and they'll stop him after a short gain. Offense needing to keep this drive alive. It's a third down play. Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. That one is incomplete. The defender was right there, and it brings up fourth down now. The field goal team to give it a shot. This is a long way out. You know the kicker has good range, but this one is from 59 yards away. And it's no good. He missed it. After that miss, it's still a four-point lead.
Boy, this guy's usually more reliable than this. I thought that was going to be an easy field goal in 3 points, but instead, he misses, so you walk away with nothing.
State offense comes back onto the field. They settle for a field goal in the last possession. They're looking for the end zone, no doubt, here. Off the play fake, looking to throw on first down. And they heave it deep downfield.
You know, if I'm the offensive coordinator, I would keep looking to throw the ball downfield. These receivers are too talented, and this quarterback has an ability to get into a rhythm, and eventually, they're going to hit some big plays.
Incompletion sets up a second down. Looking to throw. It's Howard. Makes a quick grab. They make the stop, but not before a solid gain that time.
The key on a drag route is to put the ball out in front of the wide receiver to give him a chance to do what he just did. Pick up some valuable yards after the catch.
New set of downs for the offense. First and 10. Takes the handoff, looking to throw.
receiver, pick up some positive yards, and I continue to be impressed with just the chemistry between these two.
That completion makes it second and medium. And the quarterback keeps it here. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
Man, oh man, was the defense ready for this play. The quarterback just searching for anywhere to go, looking for daylight, but couldn't find anywhere to go in the keeper.
Not going to be easy here. Backed up a long way to go for a first down. Drops back, looking to throw for it on third down. Doesn't hold on. Good hit by the DB. Now it brings up fourth down. Buckeyes will bring their punt team onto the field. Already punted five times now today. Oh, and it lands at the four and bounces in for a touchback. And the Michigan offense back out on the field. Handoff as they try to work the clock here.
Well, this is definitely not the time to get cute as an offense and as a play caller. This defense is thirsty for any kind of big play at all to try to create a turnover. So just keep it on the ground and play smart.
Second down after that run on the previous play. And the back gets the football. And the senior able to make the stop after a short gain. We head now to the two-minute warning as this offense tries to bleed out the clock and secure this win. This is a big third down play coming up. If they can get the stop, you have to believe we'd see a timeout. Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. It's an out route, the catch made. Heads out of bounds after a solid gain, more than enough to pick up a first down.
Well, I'll tell you what, this guy's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. And here we are, late in the game. He needs to continue to play with that consistency. And that's a great example that he's up to.
The Wolverines starting a new series here on first and 10. They'll go with the ground game here. Running back takes the handoff. He's found some room at the 45. Big gain across midfield. Tackle finally made at the 32. And now it's the defense that calls timeout here, trying to get organized and preserve as much clock as possible. Big chunk play, this offense operating at peak efficiency. And at first down, they go right back to him. Defense makes the stop after a 5-yard gain, so second and 5. And now a timeout taken by the defense, trying to preserve as much clock as possible for their offense. Second down after that run on the previous play. Trying to find some room. It's Edwards. They bring him down, but that's a solid gain on the play. And now it's the defense that calls timeout here, trying to get organized and preserve as much clock as possible. First down play call. How aggressive will it be? And the quarterback just kneels down.